Look at Ahmed. Look how beautiful he is, says Haytham. Ahmed is one of the protesters shot dead by Iraqi security forces. He was 27 years old. On Thursday, he joined protesters in central Baghdad. Frustrated with the lack of jobs and opportunities, he saw a chance to get his voice heard. He left home in the afternoon. He never returned. Clearly in shock, Haytham just keeps repeating how beautiful her son is. A family friend speaks on her behalf.
He didn't hurt anyone. He didn't harm anyone. What is the crime of these young men, these beautiful young men? The government is to blame. I accuse the government of murdering. He wasn't just my neighbor. He was like a son.
The government and the army say they haven't targeted protesters, but Ahmed's brother Mustafa says Ahmed was shot in the head by a sniper as he tried to help another protester who had been shot in the leg.
Some people say the shooters are Iranian. They're lying. They're from our country. It's the Iraqi army killing Iraqis.
Faleh Al-Fayed is the head of the Popular Mobilization Forces, a mainly Shia paramilitary group. He says his forces didn't take part in the operation against the protesters.
I am reaffirming that the Interior Ministry with the support from the military are the ones who stopped these protests. However, the Popular Mobilization Forces and the Peshmerga are reserve forces for the commander of the armed forces, who only interfere to fight any conspiracy whenever an order is given, and no order was given this time.
Across South and Central Iraq, people are putting up pictures of those who have been killed and placing the blame on the government. The army and the government say that they will investigate the deaths of the protesters, but that hasn't slowed the protest movement down. In fact, if anything, judging by the chants, the deaths have actually fueled the movement.